ओके तो हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ऑडिट कोड सेशन नंबर 8। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द डीसी एंड मिड बैंड गेन एनालिसिस फॉर कॉमन एमिटर कॉमन बेस डायरेक्टली कपल्ड कैस्कोड एम्पलीफायर। नाउ दिस कैस्कोड एम्पलीफायर कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू स्टेजेस। सो द फर्स्ट स्टेज इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर Q1 एंड बायसिंग रेजिस्टर्स व्हिच इज अ कॉमन एमिटर स्टेज and followed by the common base stage which is consist of transistor Q2 and the biasing resistors. So as you can see, between the first stage and the second stage, they are directly coupled. Okay, so that's why it's called as a directly coupled cascode amplifier. Now this entire circuit is powered with 20 volt DC supply, fine, and input is applied as a AC input. So let's see the DC analysis. So for the DC analysis, all the coupling capacitors, the bypass capacitors are replaced by an open circuit, because for a DC, the frequency is zero. So XC, which is the impedance offered by the capacitance, will be infinite. That is why the capacitors are replaced by open circuit at DC values. So when you do the DC analysis, this is how the circuit will reduce to. So we have marked the various terminals. Okay, so for transistor, we have marked B1, C1 and E1. And this voltage over here at the base is VB1. Similarly, for the transistor Q2, we have marked B2, E2 and C2. So as you know that E2 is connected to C1, so same current flows through the circuit. If we ignore the base current IB1 and IB2, your collector current IC2 is approximately equal to collector current IE2. Which is same as IC1, which is similar to your IE1. So the current in this branch remains almost constant. Now the various values of resistors are given: R1, R2 and R3, RC and RE, and the power supply is also given. So let's start analyzing it. So the given value is beta and beta 1 and beta 2 for both the stages are same. It is 150, and VBE1 is equal to VBE2 is equal to 0.7. We are assuming. So let us start. So as per the formula, we have, let me just expand it a little. VB1 is equal to R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 into VCC. So VB1 is R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 into VCC. So if you work out in a calculator, that number will come out to be 4.4318 volts. Next is VB2. So VB2 is R3 plus R4 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3 into VCC. So that if you work out, you will get number as 11.477 volt. Now, we can calculate VE1 as follows. We know VB1 value. We know VBE1 value. So VB1 minus VBE1 will give us VE1, which is 3.7318. Now, VE1 can be written as IE1 into RE. So what will be IE1? VE1 upon RE. Now VE1 value is given. RE1 value is around 1K. So IE1 will be 3.7318 milliamperes. Now we have already said that the current in this branch remains the same. So over here we can write IC1 is equal to IC2 is approximately equal to IE1 is approximately equal to IE2, which is 3.7318 milliamperes. So remember, this is an assumption. In actual scenario, it will be slightly different because of the amount of base current. Okay, so next is VC2 is given by VCC minus IC2 into RC. Over here, if we want to calculate VC2, VC2 will be VCC minus IC2 into RC. Okay, so if we substitute the values over here, VC2 is equal to VCC minus IC2 into RC, that number will come out to be 14.4023 volt. Now, VE2 can be written as VB2 minus VBE2. So VB2 is given. We know that value, and VBE2 is 0.7. So your VE2 will be 10.777 volt. Now, VC1 is same as VE2. Let us see that. Yeah. VC1 is same as VE2 because they are connected directly. So over here, VC1 is equal to VE2 is equal to 10.777 volt. Now VCE1 is VC1 minus VE1. That comes out to be 7.045 volt. VCE2 will be VC2 minus VE2, which comes out to be 3.625 volt. Now, since the both the stages are almost symmetric, because the current remains the same, okay, so IC1 is equal to IC2, hence we can say that the small signal parameters are slightly same. This is an approximation again. In reality, it will be slightly different. So RPi1 is equal to RPi2 is equal to beta VT upon ICQ, because we have a same ICQ flowing through the both the transistors. So that VT is around 26 millivolt, beta is given 150, and ICQ we have found out over here, which is 3.7318. So if we substitute all the values, you will get RPi1 equal to RPi2 as 1.045 kilo ohms. Similarly, GM1 and GM2 will be ICQ divided by VT. And since the current in both the transistors remains the same, ICQ, we get GM1, GM2 as 143.53 milliampere per volt. Okay. And now after that, what we do is we draw the small signal equivalent model. Okay, I'm not doing that. I'm directly getting the, writing the answers. So after we have over here, after the small signal analysis, and after drawing the small signal model, small signal equivalent circuit, we get Zin. Input impedance will be given by RC parallel to R2, parallel to R3, parallel to RPi1. And that number comes out to be 727.458 ohms. Similarly, Z out will be R3 parallel to RL, which comes out to be 1.3 kilo ohms. Now, EV mid over here is given by V out upon V in, which is V out upon V1 into V1 upon V in. Okay. So what we do over here is there are two stages, right? Let me just use the annotation now. Okay. So there are two stages. So this is your V in basically. Correct. This is your V in. Let me say this is my second output of the first stage. So this is basically your V1. Okay. And this is your V out. So how will you write it now? So AV mid will be V out divide. It will be AV1 into AV2. Okay. And in that, what will be AV1? AV1 will be V1 divided by Vin. And AV2 will be V out divided by V1. Okay. So that's what we have divided into two stages. AV1 is V1 divided by Vin, which is the common emitter stage. And AV2 is V out divided by V1. Okay, which is the common base stage. Okay, so I hope that this is clear. Let me clear out the drawings. Okay, fine. So with this, we will write the formula for AV mid. So AV mid is AV1 into AV2, which is AV2 is gain of the second stage is V out upon V1, which is given by minus GM2. Basically, GM1 and GM2 are same. That's why I'm writing over here GM only. So minus GM into RC parallel to RL. Actually, there shouldn't be a minus sign over here. I think it's a mistake. Let me just use the annotation over here. And there shouldn't be a minus sign over here. It is AV2 is GM into RC parallel to RL. And that number comes out to be 186.59. Okay. Now, AV1 is V1 upon Vin, which is given by minus GM. Again, GM1, GM2 are same. That's why I'm writing over here GM. So GM into RPi divided by 1 plus beta. So if you put all the values together, you will get AV1 as 0.9933. Okay. So that's the value you get. Let me clear out all the drawings. Okay. So your AV1 into AV2 will give us AV mid, which is 0.9933 into 186. Remember, this 186 doesn't have a minus sign. By mistake, I've written over here. So AV mid is minus 185.34. And if you take 20 log of that, you will get 45.36 dB. Okay. So let us start building the circuit in LTSpice now. So let me take this. Yeah, already the circuit is made available for your study reference. We will just compare it and check whether or everything is as per the diagram or no. Okay. So over here, this is my circuit. Let me expand it. The CV value is 10 microfarad. R1 is 7.5. R2 is 6.2. R3 is 3.9. CC1 is 1 microfarad. And this is transistor Q1, where RE is 1 kilo ohm. CE is 10 microfarad. And you have, this is transistor Q2. RC is 1.5. CC2 is 1 microfarad. And RL is 10 kilo ohm. And the power supply voltage is 20 volt. Yeah, indeed, the diagram is the same. And now we will do the DC analysis for the same. Okay, so for the DC analysis, once we take these transistors, also make sure that you name them properly. I mean to say like this. So first we'll put the label at the input and output. So here is the label. We will write V in underscore the name. Okay, and here we'll place the output label, which is V out underscore the name. Okay, secondly, we'll also label the transistor Q1 underscore the name. And this will be Q1 and Q2 underscore the name. And this we can call it as NPN1 and NPN1 itself, because okay, fine. We can call it as NPN2 also. Yeah. So right now we have to add the dot model statement. So for adding the dot model statement, we have to right click, click on the draft, click on the SPICE directive and start writing the statement. So we have dot model NPN1. NPN is the reserve word. We can write the saturation current as 2E minus 14 and beta value BF is equal to 150. Okay, so same thing we can copy for NPN2 also, because both the transistors have the similar parameters. So this is what it is. Okay, so place it onto the screen. Fine, and now let us check where the parameters are proper. Yeah, beta1, beta2 is 150, that is proper. So let me go to simulate, click on run, and click on the DC operating point and click on OK. The moment you click on OK, you will get a window. Don't refer this. So instead, what you do is, let me just take this a little up. Okay. So instead, what you do is go to view, go to SPICE error log, and here it is. These are the values which you get. Okay. Now you can compare them with the actual values which we got from the calculations. Okay. So these are the values. So VC1, first of all, IC. Here we can see clearly IC1 and IC2 are slightly different because we have base current also. And we have ignored over here the base current contribution. We have just considered that IC1, IC2 are same. So IC1 is calculated as 3.7318. And by simulation, it's coming 3.62 milliamperes. That's quite close. IC2 is 3.7318 and we are getting 6.3 milliamperes, as you can see very clearly over here. Next is VCE1. VCE1 is 7.02 simulated and calculated is 7.045 volt. VCE2 is 3.94 in simulation and by calculation is 3.625. Okay. And what about GM1 and GM2? GM1 and GM2 are slightly different. We have considered to be same as 143.53 milliampere per volt, but we are getting GM1 as 140 milliampere per volt and GM2 as 139 milliampere per volt in simulation. And RPi1 and RPi2 is also slightly different. RPi1 is 1.4 kilo ohm, 1.04 kilo ohm calculated values for both RPi1 and RPi2. And in simulation, we are getting 1.07 kilo ohm for the first transistor and RPi2 is 1.08 kilo ohms. Okay, so these are the values of DC parameters and the small signal parameters which we are getting by operating point analysis. Okay, so let me close this. And now we have to do the AC analysis. So for the AC analysis, we'll deactivate this .op. Okay. And we apply a test source. We apply an input sinusoidal signal of DC offset zero. Amplitude, peak amplitude will be 10 millivolt. So peak to peak will be 20 millivolt. Frequency is 30 kilohertz. Okay. And click on OK. And now if you go to simulate, click on run. And write here stop time as, let's say, 0.2 millisecond. The moment we write the stop time as 0.2 millisecond, automatically a new screen will come. Let me take this up. Yeah, let me simulate it again. Yeah, you get a new blank screen. So over that, you right click, click on add trace and plot V in first. And again, click on right click, add plane plot, and you plot V out also. So as you can clearly see, we have got V in and V out very, very clearly. V in is 20 millivolt peak to peak, and V out, we need to calculate it. Okay, so let's start using the dot merger statement. So over here, we will right click. We'll go to draft, go to spice directive. Basically, we are using this dot merger statement to calculate the peak to peak value. So dot merger V in peak to peak, and you save it in the variable V in underscore your name. Okay, I have labeled a node like this. Next line, if you go control M, you can type the same, but you can write over here V out. Okay, and here also V out. And next line, we'll calculate this gain. So dot measure gain param. And we'll calculate V out. We have saved it in the variable V out and V in. And we paste it onto the schematic. Okay. And now if we click on simulate and run, we get the characteristic. So do take the print screen of the circuit diagram. Do take the print screen of the output. And also take the print screen of the variables. I mean, the values now over here. So over here, we are getting now the gain as 179.094, as you can see very, very clearly, 179.094. Okay, so your calculated gain is AV mid is 185.34, and we are getting 179.094. Okay, so that's the gain which you are getting over here. Fine. Now, if you convert it into dB, it is 45.36, and by simulation, if you convert it into dB again, it is nearby 45 dB. Okay, this value I got is slightly different because I've taken a slightly different frequency maybe. So it's quite close, but it's minus. Don't confuse yourself why there is no minus sign over here. Basically, if you use the dot merger statement, it doesn't take care about the polarity. Okay, it will just give you the peak to peak. I mean, the directly the gain value, okay? Without considering the sign. So how to make sure, here if you can see, input and output are completely out of phase. Hence, there is a minus sign over here. Okay. And next is, we have calculated the, let me close this. We have calculated the DC parameters, the AC analysis. And now it's time to calculate the Zin. Okay. So to calculate Zin, what we need to do is, let me just delete this. There is no need for this dot measure statement. Neither there is a need of dot op or dot run. So what we need to do is, I'll click on label. I'll write here test. And I'll rename this source as, instead of Vin, I'll write it as test. Okay. So what is your Zin given by? Let me just write a comment over here. Zin is basically Vin divided by In. Okay. And which is equal to, over here we have applied external test source V test divided by I test. Okay, let me just place it over here. So this is how we calculate the input impedance. Input impedance looking at the base terminal of transistor Q1. Okay, and this that will be V in upon V I in. And in this case, which we have applied over here test source, so it will be V test divided by I test. Okay, and the test source, we right click over here, click on none. And we give the AC amplitude as 1. That's it. So click on that. Fine. And now we are ready to check the Zedin. So go to simulate, click on run, and click on AC analysis. Type of sweep will be decade. Number of points, you give it 100. Start frequency will be 1K. End frequency will be 1 mega ohms. Or we can give it 10 mega ohms. Okay. And we get this graph. X-axis is the frequency. We'll right-click, add trace. We select V-test and divided by I-test. Okay, so this will give us directly the Zin. So let me delete this phase plot and let me change this to linear. Okay, so this is how we get this value. So over here, we have to check it at 30 kilohertz. So why 30? Because we have given the input frequency as 30. And around 30, nearby 30, we are getting 745.17 ohms. Okay. So, yeah, Zin is 727.45 ohms as calculated value. And the simulated value is coming out to be 745, to be precise, 0.17 ohms. Okay. So, that is the difference. It's quite close, 727 and 745. Are you okay? So, that's the value which we get. And yeah, because the difference is coming because RPi calculated and simulated is slightly different. And now Z out. So for Z out, what we need to do is, let me just copy this statement over here. So Z out is looking into the collector terminal of the transistor Q2. So let me rephrase it as Z out is equal to V out divided by I out. Okay, so we'll have to delete this. Okay. And test source, I can take it from here itself. Okay, and I place it over here. Okay, don't remove the resistor, basically. Or you can remove the resistor and then add parallel whatever value you get. So this, I am renaming it as test. So conditions are same. Okay, so just you have to simulate it. It will automatically get Z out. So here you see, automatically we are getting the value of Z out. And at 30 kilohertz, we will get the value properly. Okay, this is close to 30 kilohertz. We are getting 1.304 kilo ohms. Okay, and the calculated value should be 1.3 kilo ohms, and we are getting 1.304 kilo ohms. So that's quite close. Okay, so that's how you calculate the DC analysis, the AC analysis, and the Zin and Z out for a cascode amplifier. Okay, now let's go back to the PDF. After this exercise is over, after this analysis, and one, this was an example, there are two exercises. All the resistor values and capacitors values being the same, only change RC value to 2.7 kilo ohm. So over here, RC value is given as 1.5. Just change it to 2.7 and repeat the entire analysis. Okay. So either you can directly start with this 2.7 kilo ohm, or you can build in on this and then add it to 2.7 and note down everything. What you need to note down is what all parameters are getting affected by changing RC. Okay. Now rest all same. Second part is rest all same. Only change RE to 720 ohm. Now RE value was given as around 1 kilo ohm, so decrease it to 720 and see what all parameters are getting affected by it. Fine. So that's how we complete this common emitter, common base, directly coupled amplifier, or we can call it as a cascode amplifier. And we have seen its DC analysis, mid band gain analysis, and input and output impedance estimation using calculations as well as in LTSpice. So that's all for today. Next time we'll start with CSCD, directly coupled cascode amplifier, which is MOSFET based. So until then, have a good day and thank you.